Good morning, Bitcoin. Good morning, everybody. Good morning, Bitcoin 10K. Yes, we are entering my office again. And Bitcoin this morning, I wake up with this huge green candle. I can see Bitcoin 10K. You can see the smile on my face. It is low tide. We have a full moon today. The full moon has triggered many Bitcoin events, even crashes, but also huge run-ups. There will be some information about that in this video. Of course, we're going to talk about the CEO of Morgan Creek, what he is expecting for Bitcoin. We are going to talk about a lot of other things, but I think this video mainly about the Bitcoin price. I'm going to make a short video because I'm going to drive around Copangan with a few friends today and they want to meet very early, so I don't have much time to edit this video and put it online. Good morning again on my beautiful office in Copangan. Great chat yesterday, guys, with Sean from Hardforking and Alexandro from Poolin. Poolin is one of the biggest Bitcoin mining pools at the moment. I think they're responsible for 18% of the mining. So this is a huge pool. It was a great chat. Soon you will see the video on Hardforking channel. Goedemorgen. Yes, we have some Dutch people here in the Island of Oil. Of course, it's a huge Dutch colony. No, it isn't. But there are some Dutch people. So that was a great chat with Poolin, and Alessandro is a great guy. I got to know him yesterday and we had a great chat. And I think we will meet each other some more in the future because we have the same vision about Bitcoin. And that's just cool to meet these guys online. And I'm looking forward to see you in real life, Alexandro. It made me think again about all the Bitcoin mining I did in the early days and all the problems I had, and now how everything has developed in the mining space. It was a cool chat. I will post the link as soon as possible when it's available, and you will be able to see that chat. I read something this morning as well about a new social media platform. I think it's a social media platform built on the blockchain, where it is incentivizing people in crypto. I think it's called CoinLinked. Just check it. I will put the link below. I checked the website. I cannot download the app or anything yet. So I could see there was they're preparing an App Store app and a Google Play Store app. Yes, I'm walking into the water because I was being stung by mosquitoes. Itchy. And you know, these the start should have been on the 7th of May. So I read something about it. So just check it. Social media, decentralizing. Yes, two things I love. Okay, guys, I think that was the chit chat news. You are all waiting on me now saying something about Bitcoin and the Bitcoin price. And that is exactly what I'm going to do now. Bitcoin. Bitcoin, man. Even Paul Tudor, he's one of the billionaires around this beautiful globe. He has an investment fund called, I think, Tudor Investment. He now said, oh guys, I am going to hedge into Bitcoins. Why? Because I think Bitcoin will be the savior, like gold was the savior in the 70s, in the huge problems we had faced at that point. Gold saved us by hedging into gold. Now I think this huge crisis, I'm going to hedge into Bitcoin because I think Bitcoin will save us from making losses. And that's why we all need to hedge into Bitcoin. Thank you, Paul Tudor, for supporting Bitcoin and the community. And hope all your billionaire friends, if you have many, please send them a text message, hedge into Bitcoin. That will drive the price of Bitcoin even more up. And yes, indeed, you will then all understand the true fundamentals of Bitcoin. And Bitcoin will lift off to the moon together with all the people that are now investing. And you know, guys, that are a lot of people. Because we see all-time high in Bitcoin wallets till 1 BTC. I think we have more than 8 million Bitcoin wallets that now hodl more up to 1 BTC. I think we have about 3 million Bitcoin addresses that hodl up to 0.1 BTC. So that's huge amount of addresses that have small amounts of BTC. We also already stated last week that there is an all-time high in, you know, Bitcoin whales wallets. So that's the wallets that hold more than 1,000 BTC. We also see all-time high in there. So we are all accumulating Bitcoin, and this is really cool. Of course, this is one of the reasons why we see this price go up. The halving, everybody is excited about this halving. Nobody knows what is going to happen after the halving. Many people are expecting a post-halving dump, as they call it. You know, I really don't know. As I say many times, I am not the best TA. I like to read about it. I like to make my conclusions. Yes, and we made some profit as a family because probably I took the right bet, decisions, whatever you call it. You know, but many people think now, oh, Bitcoin is going to have a pullback after the halving, and this is going to go back to, whew, let's say, 8,800, because there is a huge region of support. There is about 1.5 million addresses, Bitcoin wallets that bought Bitcoin around 8,800. On the other side, we have a huge resistance, should have a huge resistance at 9,500, because about 1.2 million wallets accumulated Bitcoin around 9,500, but we just destroyed this. I just saw this green candle going up to 10K already. So that was, so you never know what support and resistance we might break or not hold. You know, it's now too difficult to predict what the emotions of the whole community are going to do. But if it comes to the miners, guys, that is what people are now afraid of. People are afraid of that post the halving, the miners are going to sell off because they need to break even with their mining cost. Let me tell you this. This can be true, but if you look at the metrics, you can see that the miners are hodling their Bitcoins at the moment. They are not exchanging their Bitcoins. And to be honest, if you look at the halving, that means that the cost of mining will increase. In my opinion, I think the cost of mining will be after the halving somewhere between 12 and 15K. The Bitcoin price needs to go to that area for the miners to even break even or make some extra profit, you know, so that they can break even in the future when we have this pullback. So many miners are calling Bitcoin going higher than 12K, because that is their cost of mining after the halving, which would be really cool. But I think we have a huge resistance at 10,500. But then again, it's Bitcoin. Bitcoin is breaking resistance like it's nothing, like a knife through this beautiful butter. You know, it's going through all these levels at the moment. Of course, it's healthy to see some pullbacks, but you know, we also need to consider the cost of mining, because these guys are supporting the network. These guys are responsible for keeping the network safe. These guys are responsible for making it possible that you and I transact Bitcoin with each other. So why would we leave these people in loss? And why would themselves choose to be in loss? They will choose to be in profit. And that's why I think that Bitcoin also needs to go above 10K, and we slowly will go into this bull run. That together, of course, with the guy, with all the indicators I was speaking about the last few days in my videos, you know, I told you about the MACD crossing, I told you about the SAR indicator started to flashing, I told you that Bitcoin was above the 50, 100 and 200 weekly simple moving average. So all these things I've been saying the last week, we are now seeing in the charts. Bitcoin went above 10K. I know we are below 10K again a little bit now, but you know, that is only healthy if you see such a huge run to pull back and to run again. And hopefully the miners will be right and that we will see 12K or more as soon as possible, so that these guys and companies and individuals and mining pools stay profitable in keeping this beautiful technology very safe and secure, because that is what they exactly do. If we look at the Bitcoin active addresses at the moment, the active used Bitcoin addresses grew with 74% since the beginning of 2020. This is huge. This is a huge number. We haven't seen this growth and this many active addresses since 2017, before the bull run. Another indicator we are going to see Bitcoin going up. As I said before in the video, a lot of small cap wallets, which means a lot of normal people are entering the market as well, or which means that the hodlers are now making new addresses and sending, you know, their bitcoins from their ledger wallets into new addresses from exchanges so that they can exchange their bitcoins into Tether or whatever they want to change them into if they think they can, if we see a top, you know, because that is what I do as well. If I see Bitcoin going near 12, I will exchange a part of my portfolio, like say 20% into US dollar Tether or into Pax, and then wait for Bitcoin to drop again to 10K and accumulate more Bitcoin. This is the game you need to play if you live an all-in life on Bitcoin and you don't have a normal job and you just spend time vlogging and making content for people all over the world. Yeah, we need to make some cryptocurrency as well a little bit, because else my kids would be screaming out of hunger and, you know, not that happy with their dad not providing. Okay, the last bullish news, guys. The CEO of Morgan Creek is expecting, listen very carefully, the CEO of Morgan Creek is expecting a 100k Bitcoin in 2021. 100k Bitcoin in 2021. That is next year, for the people that don't realize which year we are living in because of the lockdown. It is 2020. Next year is 2021, and this CEO of Morgan Creek is expecting a 100k Bitcoin. So 10k now is a very, very, very cheap buy. I would really start to accumulate Bitcoin and trust these billionaires, because they are mostly right when it comes to the market. There is only one that didn't understand Bitcoin. Oh, you know, Warren Buffet, my guy, not 100% of the billionaires can be right, but most of them, they understand the market. And the market is saying, buy Bitcoin, hedge against the fiat currency, because we will see a huge crisis and that will devalue many other assets and not Bitcoin. Okay, and the last thing, guys, it is full moon here on Thailand, and probably full moon all over the world. Normally we would be celebrating the full moon party with the family. This time there is in the lockdown, they don't celebrate or allow to celebrate the full moon party. But why am I talking about the full moon? Because if you look at the chart I'm sharing here below, you can see that the full moon has triggered a lot of events in Bitcoin. Not only the bull runs, but also the crashes. We just saw a full moon yesterday evening. And so please check the chart, because it's really interesting. There's also a link to the article speaking about this, because it's really interesting to see that every full moon, you know, we saw this huge run or huge crash. This moon is a very special full moon, because they call this one the flower full moon. Why the flower full moon? Because it's taking us from the winter into the spring and the summer, and then the flowers start to flourish again. So if you compare this to the Bitcoin market, this flower full moon will take us from the crypto winter we have been living in the last years to the Bitcoin bull run and the crypto summer, where we all will be happy spending our Bitcoins on beaches like this one here in Koh Phangan, Thailand. Guys, thank you very much for watching the video again. Please subscribe to the channel, please give it a thumbs up, and please share the video with your friends and family so they get some education about Bitcoin and life. I know this video was not a lot of education about life, but I promise you I will talk more about this life stuff in the next couple of videos, because I need to hurry up, I need to prepare, because we're going to leave for a beautiful motorbike ride across the island. I will make some beautiful videos which I will add to the video tomorrow, so you will have the beautiful view again on Koh Phangan in tomorrow's video. And do remember, guys, one very important thing: we are all one huge Bitcoin family, and that is why I'm wearing this shirt today, the Bitcoin family. See you tomorrow, guys.